Five things I wish I knew before I started medical school. Number one, how long it was gonna be. Yeah, I know, everybody tells you it's 4 years of medical school and then you have to do residency on top of that. And the number of years of residency greatly varies with what you end up deciding for your specialty, but no one's really sat me down and said, hey, 3 years of residency is the minimum if you plan on doing family medicine, emergency medicine, IM, or pediatrics. And during that time, you're essentially being paid the same salary, which doesn't really change that much during the 3 years. And to even begin to think about specializing, you're gonna have to add at least a year to that. Even if you want to be doing something like neurology, physical medicine and rehabilitation, anesthesia, or even psychiatry, even that is actually still 4 years. And if you want to be practicing any of the other specialties on top of that, you're going to have to add even more years, especially if you want to end up doing a fellowship, something that no one's really sat me down and told me. Because before then, yeah, you've got your pre-med counselor, you've got people who are sort of telling you about medical school, but no one's really telling you the ins and outs and the nitty gritty detail of exactly how long it's gonna take, especially depending on what you wanna end up doing. That being said, number two is I wish I knew a little bit more about the subspecialties that I could go into. I mean, yeah, we all get to see our family medicine physician or pediatrician, maybe a surgeon or two, and maybe if you were lucky enough, you were a medical scribe for a different specialty such as emergency medicine. But aside from that, the majority of people who apply to medical schools may not have seen a lot of different subspecialties that may be available to them down the road. And why is that such a big deal? Because as crazy as it sounds, you're gonna have to apply to a medical specialty as early as third year of medical school. That's extremely early to be deciding something that you wanna be doing for the rest of your life. And by that point in med school, you've probably learned the ins and outs of general medicine, but I have to say each of the medical subspecialties is so vastly different that they're literally almost like different careers. For example, a plastic surgeon has a completely different lifestyle and career path compared to a radiologist. And knowing what specialty you'd want to go into even before applying to medical school could help you with research down the road, especially for some of the harder subspecialties. I wish I knew how hard it was to match as a DO into those harder subspecialties. You can look this up online and you'll probably hear it time and time again. As an osteopathic medical student, it is generally harder to match some of the more competitive specialties such as dermatology, orthopedic surgery, general surgery, plastics, IR, radiology, and ophthalmology. Oh, add in their ENT. Now, I knew that I wasn't necessarily gonna be going into the majority of those subspecialties, but it just would have been nice knowing that it was gonna be a little bit harder as a DO to match, let alone matching to something like a community program versus a big university hospital. Luckily, I did match, but even then, just realize that if you're gonna be applying to osteopathic schools, know that it's gonna be a little bit harder for you versus your MD counterparts. I wish I knew more about more schools. And by that, I mean, I wish I had known about more of the options that I had to applying to US schools and had applied broader. At the end of the day, you really wanna be giving yourself all the opportunities you can so that you increase your chance of getting an acceptance letter. And it may not necessarily be in the state or geographical location that you want to be in, but again, you've got to be giving yourself these opportunities because down the road it will pay off. You'd be surprised at some of the places that you may eventually call home, even if initially you didn't really think you'd want to be living in that sort of location. Because at the end of the day, if medical school is what you want to do, getting accepted somewhere is better than getting accepted nowhere. And you'd hate to find yourself without an acceptance letter if you just did not apply broadly enough. Yeah, it's going to cost money, but this is the front-end investment. Five, I wish I knew more about finances. Many of us who go into medical school or apply typically get degrees in biology, chemistry, biochemistry, biochemical engineering, physics, physiology. The list goes on in terms of science-related degrees. That doesn't necessarily mean that you need one of those degrees to apply to medical school, you just need the prerequisite classes and have taken the MCAT. But that being said, the medical field is notoriously known for not being very good with finances because a lot of us don't necessarily take a formal class and are not taught some of the consequences that could come of taking out a big student loan for graduate school. This affects your credit score and affects whether or not you'd be offered a mortgage loan down the road if you wanted to take out another loan to buy a house, for example, and can definitely add a large amount of stress on your shoulders throughout medical school and throughout your training during residency because at that time you're really not getting paid a lot. There you have it. Those are the things I wish I knew before I started medical school. I don't think that would have changed my decision, but it definitely would have made me feel more prepared for medical school and taking out student loans. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Comment and compliment below. Please subscribe and follow, and good luck.